Somebody's here. Hey, James. How are you, sir? Excuse me while I hydrate. Okay, better. Woo! Let me copy this and paste it onto Facebook. Right there, we'll copy. Then right there, we paste and post. So there, now they can see it. And all right. So how's everybody doing? James, you were the first one here, man. What do you want to hear? Let me pop that down a little bit. There we go. That should work. Is that kind of even? I think we're okay. Well, James gets the first request since he was the first one to pop on this morning. Good morning, Regis Ann. James says, how about critters? Hey, Yussi, how are you, man? Critters. All right, let's get that going here. First thing in the morning. Woo! Critter gonna crawl where it's dark and dank. Shrimp gonna boil. Oh, hound dog gonna howl at the moon. I fly like a baby not in June. Critter gonna crawl, I'm gonna fall for you. Cricket gonna fiddle. Froggy gonna crawl. Armadillo in the middle. Porcupine gonna poke. Well, you never seen a horse like a Tennessee stud. Catfish gonna swim in Mississippi mud. Critter gonna crawl, I'm gonna fall for you. When it come to what I have in between me and you, nature gonna do what nature gonna do. Moon gonna shine, planet gonna spin. Fox gonna sneak in a chicken pen. Fox gonna sneak in a chicken pen. Hey! When it come to what I have in between me and you, nature gonna do what nature gonna do. Moon gonna shine, planet gonna spin. Fox gonna sneak in a chicken pen. Fox gonna sneak in a chicken pen. Oh no, those strays. Oh, snakey gonna hiss. Bumblebee gonna buzz. Skeeter gonna stick, yeah, yeah. When he looking for the blood. Every mob gonna flutter to an open flame. Love bug, about your baby, never be the same. Critter gonna crawl and I'm gonna fall for you. Said every mob gonna flutter to an open flame. Don't hate the player, baby, hate the game. Critter gonna crawl, I'm gonna fall for you. Da 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 da. Critter gonna crawl. road and I'm gonna make it home tonight. Wow, well, that is a way to get started in the morning, James. You don't mess around, do you? James is like, no, I want full speed ahead. Torpedoes be damned. Regis said her California grandkids are in town. Well, that's exciting. Are they from Southern California or Northern California? You know, I was born in Southern California, raised in Oregon, but then as adults, we lived in SoCal for, I don't know, 7-8 years or something like that. But anyways, hello, Regis Ann's grandkids. Let's talk about Granny for a minute, you know, and by the way, it's Friday. I think that's Southern. Oh, San Francisco? SFO, San Francisco? Or SFO is shut? No. Okay. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Pipe all like the whiskey and threw a little dice. Aunt Louita did it, Uncle Buddy too. They had a ball last call, howling at the moon. We carry the tradition, our family taught us right. And Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night, yeah. Mama loved to dance, shake it left, shake it right. She'd flash a little leg and drive the fellas wild. Daddy had a hot rod Chevy 63, burn a rubber through the town till he wrapped around a tree. He hung out with the rallies, they'd cuss and smoke and fight. And Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Now she's knitting mittens and baking berry pie. Wish she was a real firecracker in her time. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night, yeah. Well, we ain't doing nothing. He ain't been done before. Since way back when some of good old boys threw sawdust on the floor. Our family tree's been growing underneath a neon light. And Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Yeah, yeah. Saturday tailgating party with the fam. Got dogs and burgers cooking, cold beer in a can. Sunday finds us singing with the choir, sitting in the front pew catching hellfire. The Bible told me Jesus turned the water into wine. And Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Now she's knitting mittens and baking cherry pie. Wish she was a real firecracker in her time. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Now she's knitting mittens and baking apple pie. We carry the tradition, our family taught us right. Oh, Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Granny used to honky-tonk every Friday night. Aye, aye, aye. There you go, Miss Regis Ann. And by the way, Frank Martin Gilligan is here. Frank Martin Gilligan, how are you, man? Where are you playing at tonight? Frank's always gigging. He is one of the hardest working men I know. Yeah, let's tell our friends where you're playing. I know we got some Texas folks that watch this, if not right on time, they come in and watch it later. You should all follow Frank on YouTube. He just released a brand new music video to what is one of my absolute favorite songs of his called Silver Dollar. So you should all go check that out. Follow him, subscribe to his page, and like his videos.
One of the, now, if you guys were fans of Mason Dixon in the 80s, he was the lead singer of Mason Dixon and still is. I mean, they still go out and tour occasionally. And but man, as a solo artist, a writer, a singer, vocalist, good stuff. Y'all just go follow him. You'll thank me later. I appreciate it. UC in Finland, what do you feel like listening to? Sandra's here. Hi, Sandra. Good morning, Scott. Good to see and hear you again. I, too, used to honky-tonk. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. And I believe you still do every now and then, I bet. I'm just betting. Larry, you have been on my mind, sir. I'm going to be playing in Prairie du Chien next month. I think the middle of next month. On a Saturday, and I'm thinking you and I should talk and see if there's something we can do on Friday. Maybe a little coffee shop, or even maybe a little early spring house concert somewhere. So let's chat maybe tomorrow. Today's going to be a mess, but let's try to talk tomorrow. Drinking for two and me without my capo. Do I have my capo? I do not. Do I have another capo here? How prepared am I? I do. I don't like this capo, but I like UC, so I'm gonna do this, and I hope it works. That works all right. This was a gift. A very nice gift from somebody, and I'm just not enamored with the actual style of not the style, but the how it works, the effectiveness of this particular capo. And it's not like he spent money and bought this specifically for me. It was like a promo item, but he gave it to me, so that was nice of him, and I appreciate it, because right now it's going to help me do this song since I wasn't fully prepared. All right. This, by the way, I'm releasing as a single on May 10th, and I'm trying to do a video. We'll see. Bow na now na now na now na now na now. Now I'm drinking for two, for me and for you. You're gonna need it, man. You hear that buzzing? That's a capo. When she's through, she'll make you love her. And here's what she'll do. Da 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 da. Leave you here crying. Drinking for two. You've been wrapped around her finger since the minute that you seen her circling around this bar. It only took one little grin to reel you in and sink a hook into your foolish heart. Pop, pop, she'll give you lovey-dovey till you're out of money, then be gone in a wink of an eye. From right here where I'm sitting, man, I see it every honky-tonk night. I'm drinking for two, for me and for you. You're gonna need it, man, whenever she's through. She'll make you love her, and here's what she'll do. Da da da, leave you here crying. No, drinking for two. Bow. Well, I know you don't believe me. I've been in your boots, and somebody tried to warn me as well. But when a heart breaks, you're walking at you looking so cute. Some things you gotta learn for yourself. I'm drinking. I'm drinking for two. I really don't like that capo, do I? For me and for you. You're gonna need it, man, whenever she's through. She'll make you love her, and here's what she'll do. Leave you here crying, drinking for two. Hey, she made me love her, now I'm just one more fool, sitting there crying, drinking for two. When I'm sitting there crying, drinking for two. Well, I'm sitting there crying, drinking for two. Drinking for two, written with my buddy Heino Moeller. Good old Heino. He and I were co-hosts on the radio show we did for 10 years called The Music Row Show. You're welcome, Yusey. Thank you for the request. Hey, Brad, I'm trying to envision the video for this one. So many possibilities. Well, I'm doing this one a little different because I've done the stories in the bars. I've done that a couple times, so... I'm just trying something really different. It may work out. It may be a total cluster, in which case it'll never see the light of day, but we'll see. We'll see if this silly brain of mine has an idea that's worth it. UC says, our winter is not over yet. Still snow and woo. Wow, all right then. Wow, well, we just had our second fake spring, and then we had 3 days of chilly weather, nothing like you, but cold weather, you know. So you can always tell people that just moved to Tennessee because they've already put away all their flannels and everything. And now they're having to pull everything out. So, Mike Woolley, holy goodness, look at you up so early. What is it? It's 5:17 in the morning. Who the heck gets up to listen to me at 5 in the morning? Mike Woolley does. Wow. Mike has been my best friend since 8th grade. What do you think about that? So, anyways, let me tell you what's been going on. I wanted to wait till a few people got on here, but... So, our puppy, Annie, went in for surgery, routine surgery yesterday. She got spayed. And then she had a little growth that really popped up quick on her chest. So we figured, well, since you're you're already putting her out to do the spay, go ahead and take that thing off too. So they did. And then I don't know what happened because the vet said that it was just on the skin. It wasn't like a deep rooted type of growth. So she took it off, but then they sutured it and stapled it. Long story short, when we went to pick her up, she'd had the wound packed and bandaged like 3 or 4 times. And, that's true, James, you do too. And they said, you know, gosh, we don't know if maybe... They were kind of trying to say, had she eaten some rat poison? Do you guys keep rat poison laying around? Well, no, we don't. But, you know, it seems like she's not coagulating. We've had to keep redressing this. So I'm like, well, all right, well, we'll keep an eye on it. And so we got 5 steps out of the vet, and she has blood pouring down both of her legs. So I said, no, get back out here, and what are we going to do? And they, and you know, it's 5:30. They're like, we're closing. So anyways, so then we had to take her to an emergency vet, and she's been there all night while they tried to stop the bleeding and get it to coagulate. They did do a coagulation test, and she's fine. So I know they were trying to make it sound like maybe it was something we did or something like that, but what I believe happened, this part of a dog is where pretty much all the veins and arteries go to the, you know, this is like a central nervous system for all the veins. So I'm betting whoever closed her up probably nicked one or two veins right there. So anyway, so we're very concerned, but we did already talk to him at like 5 this morning. It's a 24-hour place, and sounds like they have stopped the they've stopped the bleeding without having to. They were afraid they were going to have to go back in and cauterize some things, but I think she's okay. I think she's okay, but I'm going to pick her up this afternoon. But anyway, so I didn't get home till we didn't get home. It was a late night for us. Yeah, she will come home to the cone of shame. Absolutely. We tried to get one of those inflatable ones. We have two of the regular ones. You know, when you got three dogs, you always want to have a couple on hand. But we got an inflatable one just because it's easier to maneuver. It didn't go as far out, but because it's inflatable, it kept her from putting her head too far down to lick anything. But she had that thing off in 32 seconds. So we need the one that we can attach to the collar. Has there ever been a song written about the cone of shame? I don't know. Thanks, Mikey. Me too. Me too. It was a stressful, I mean, just to see. And when we got to the emergency room, she was really lethargic. And she, like, so I picked her up, you know, I pick up the 70-pound dog and take her into the hospital, and there's blood dripping. And they didn't, it wasn't even a, we'll fill these out and somebody will be with you. No, they came running, they grabbed her, took her back. And then, you know, Jen and I are both covered in blood and had to get cleaned up. And then finally got to fill stuff out. But it was, you know, normally anytime you go to any type of emergency room, and there were people waiting with their dogs, but this was just, we walked in and they're like, oh, we got it. And they just took her and off they went. So stressful. Stressful indeed. I just had a terrible thought. I'm not going to share it, but yeah. Anyways, so there you go. This weekend, and I'm leaving tomorrow morning. My poor wife. This stuff seems to happen when I'm leaving town, or I'm just leaving town all the time, and life happens around it. But I'm going to be in Canton, Georgia tomorrow, playing a private event that I'm very excited about and happy to be a part of. So that'll be nice. And then I may come home tomorrow night. Or I might stay then. I don't know. We'll see what happens. We'll see how the puppy's doing and if Jen needs me. What else you guys want to hear? I guess what I'm trying to get to is I have no agenda or set list or even thoughts in my head right now. So you tell me what you want to hear, and if I can, I'll play it. In the twilight, I can see her. There it is. Blue eyes crying in the rain. when we kissed goodbye and parted. I knew we'd never meet again. Love is like a dying ember, only memories remain. And through the ashes I remember blue eyes crying in the rain. Hey, Trevor. Someday when we meet up yonder, we'll stroll hand in hand again. In a land that knows no parting, blue eyes crying in the rain. Blue eyes crying in the rain. That song's been in my head for the last few weeks for some reason. That and Cowboys ain't easy to love and they're harder to hold. They'd rather give you a song than diamonds or gold. Another quarter shirt, Lone Star belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. If you don't understand him, he don't die young, he'll probably just ride away. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and ride them old trucks. Help them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys, 'cause they never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Cowboys like smoky old pole rooms and clear mountain mornings, little warm puppies and babies and girls of the night. Them that don't know him won't like him, and them that do sometimes won't know how to take him. He ain't wrong, he's just different. His heart won't let him do things to make you think that he's right. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Help them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys, 'cause they never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. 'Cause they never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Got that in the program next week. Weekend. What's that? Mamas don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys? Oh, with Trey Ed Bruce. Trey Bruce. I was thinking of Trey, his son. Sorry. Yeah, great song. Okay, Mike asked for this one. Ba 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 la 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 la. Our friends were taking bets. Hey, oddly enough, Mike was in that wedding party that I sing about in this song. It was him and Danny on one side and Jill and Chrissy on the other side. And they were betting on how long this whole thing would last. So that's that part of this. Actually, pretty much every part of this song is true. Our friends were taking bets how long this thing would last as they stood beside us on our wedding day. Well, honey, we sure proved them wrong. 25 years holding on. Two young foolish lovers blew them odds away. Living on white bread and rice, pinching pennies, stretching dimes. We was good back then and barely getting by. But just look how far we've come, still together, still in love. Oh, honey, let's put another quarter in the ride. We've won and lost, laughed and cried throughout our stories. We've had for better and for worse. We can't say we've had boring. Well, love's crazy, no doubt. Roller coaster up and down. Say it's all been fun, well, that would be a lie. Yeah, it would, but you know what? Yeah, we made it through it all, standing like that China wall. Honey, let's put another quarter in the ride. Well, we won and lost, laughed and cried throughout our story. Had for better and for worse. We can't say we've had boring. Oh, yeah, the hard work's all been done. The kids are grown and gone. What's next? It's up to us to redefine. There's a great big world to see. Let's go find it. Let's put another quarter in the ride. Na, 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 na. Let's put another quarter in the ride. Yep, ba, ba, da, 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 da. There you go for Mike Woolley, and I know that that's Trevor's, one of his favorite songs, so it might be his favorite song of mine. So there you go. Good coffee this morning. Rachel's driving. Well, good morning, and be careful out there, Rachel. Those Oklahoma drivers are nuts. This segment brought to you by the Oklahoma Department of Motor Safety. Wooden sheriff's gun. Well, Sandra, let me see. I might try it. You know, I stopped playing that in January and don't touch it till November. So we'll see how the old memory banks are working. Fingers to work. He was a lawman in Texas, and he always got his man.
year was 1883. Snow was falling Christmas Eve, and the trail was closing in. He knew he'd find his runner in that patch of trees, probably scared to death and just about to freeze. But I came out hands up in the air with a grin from ear to ear, and I was holding a wooden sheriff's gun. I was holding a wooden sheriff's gun. I said, I'm sorry for the goose chase, but I couldn't go to jail until I got this done. I know you've heard it all before, sir, but could you please take this to my son? He's a good boy, the only thing I've done right. He still believes that magic comes on Christmas night. And when he wrote to Santa Claus, the only thing that he asked for was a wooden sheriff's gun. Was a wooden sheriff's gun. Silent night, holy night, that lawman had me dead to right. He said it's a two-day ride back to jail. Maybe we could stop and you could give it to the boy yourself on the way. Well, my wife burst into tears when I walked through that door. And that little boy, well, he jumped right into my arms. I introduced the lawman to my family. He said, pleased to meet you, but we can't stay long. But my wife said, well, you both look half frozen from the cold. And I'll have Christmas dinner on the table for you know. And that little boy, he ran all around with a grin from ear to ear when I handed him his wooden sheriff's gun. When I handed him his wooden sheriff's gun. Silent night, holy night, that lawman had me dead to right. He sat down at our table and broke bread. And when he offered to say grace, well, we all bowed down our head and said a prayer. We said a prayer. Our belly's full, boots are dry. It's time to hit the trail. I saddled up my horse for one last ride. My wife packed some food and held me tight, not wanting to let go. And the lawman looked my son right in the eyes. He said, we'll be gone for a while, me and your dad. Yeah, we still got a lot of bad guys left to catch. And then he pulled the badge right off his vest and he gave it to my son. He said, you need a star to pull a wooden sheriff's gun, boy. You need a star to pull a wooden sheriff's gun. Silent night, holy night, that lawman had me dead to rights. And when he locked me up, I proudly shook his hand, because he gave me one more night to be a dad and a hero to my son.
with a wooden sheriff's gun. Silent night, holy night. There you go, Sandra. Man, oh man. That's it's funny how truly once the season's over, it's like a vault that goes into a vault in my cobweb-filled brain. So to remember any of that is pretty amazing. Oh my goodness, Larry, you're killing me. I found a song I've not heard in a long time. It's a farm thing. We plant that seed till our backs are bent and our knuckles bleed. Have faith all year. Oh, no, that's not right. We live, we die by the dirt in the ground and the rain from the sky. We cuss, we pray for every single acre, every single day, weekends. Ah, what's that, Larry? There ain't no days off when the crop gets fat. So plow, grab a train, fill that hopper, load the grain. It's a farm thing, early morning, gotta hit them chores. Putting in a hard day all day till you can't work no more. We ain't got much to say, but we say just what we mean. It's a farm thing. We plant that seed till our backs are bent and our knuckles bleed. Have faith all year. Ain't no diet. You don't know until the crop gets here. Hey, gambling man, you ain't gone all in till you bet on land. So roll the dice and let it fly. Jackpot hits if the crop is high. It's a farm thing, early morning, gotta hit them chores. Putting in a hard day all day till you can't work no more. Got much to say, but we say just what we mean. It's a farm thing. I said, hey, hey. I said, hey, gotta bale that hay, work that dirt and bust that clay. Feels like rain, hope it pays. I heard Joe King say it on the market day. It's a farm thing. Gotta hit them chores, putting in a hard day working till you can't work no more. We ain't got much to say, but we say just what we mean. We ain't got much to say, but we say just what we mean. It's a farm thing. It's a farm thing, baby. I said, hey. Wow. Wow. That took me down memory lane, too. Of course, Larry, I appreciate it. So I don't know if you guys are seeing. I had to do something since I'm now considered a YouTube partner, although I'm not fully there. There's one more level I need to get to before I'm fully monetized. I just got tired of talking about it for a while, but I did have to put one of these things up. So if you can add stickers and pin your comment to be first or to stay there for a while, And I don't know what it costs, but what I decided is any income that's generated from the stickers is just going to go to video production. I'm just going to earmark that money to elsewhere. So if you feel inclined, if you're going to tip anyway, go ahead and try that. And if you weren't, then that's God bless you. That's fine. And then also, what also helps the algorithm and helps me out is as you're watching this, there's a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Hit the thumbs up. Let you know there's a handful of, there's 10 of you watching right now. If 10 of you hit that, then that makes YouTube show, you know, the more people that hit the like button and share button, it helps keep pushing me out. YouTube will push it out to more people if they see that it's getting pushed out to more people anyway. Does that make sense? So anyway, if you don't mind, hit like and the little thumbs up there underneath the screen, and there's a share if you feel like it. I had a request for Old Bones, my good old Mike Woolley. Scott Lucatus is here. Hey, Scott. Let me tell you about my buddy Scott Lucatus. He has a cool life. He, in the spring and summer, he gets to travel all over the U.S. He goes to all these motocross and racing events all over the place, hot rods and motorbikes and dirt bikes and all sorts of motorized. If it has a motor and they can race it, Scott's there. He has a product called Engine Ice for all different types of engines and such. But it's very, very cool stuff. So you should check out my buddy Scott, and you should he always has great photos and stuff from his on Instagram. A lot of great. What's your Instagram handle, Scott? If you like racing, if you like motorbikes and cars and stuff, that's a good one to check out. All right, Mikey, here you go. There you go, NJ Motocross. So check that out on Instagram. These old bones sure like complaining when they get me out of bed. I don't mind the ache and pain, and good to know that I ain't dead. These old bones don't get nowhere fast, but they got me this far. These old bones, they like picking on an old flat-top guitar. Don't know much, but one thing I know for sure, these old bones ain't ever been this old before. It's harder to recuperate, they don't bounce back like they did. But when the whiskey lubricates, hell, they feel just like kids. These old bones don't dance, truth to tell, they never really could. These old bones got enough to know that they still got it good. I don't know much, but one thing I know for sure, these old bones ain't never been this old before. You might call me a fossil, relic past my prime, but my baby likes the way these old bones take their time. They're what God gave me to work with until he calls me home. Said, I got these old bones. And so does Mike Woolley. I can tell you that right now. Woo! Well, I ain't planning on these old bones getting planted no time soon. Still, let's see here. Plenty left I'm gonna do, and plenty left to do. Long as guitars pick it hot, and honky tonks serve beer on ice. Well, you can keep that chair to rock, cause of these old bones just to hit their prime. I don't know much, but one thing I know for sure, these old bones ain't never felt this good before. You
might call me a fossil, a relic past my prime, but my baby likes the way that these old bones take their time. They're what God gave me to work with until he calls me home. Oh, 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 oh. Said, I got these old bones. Said, I got these old bones. And when I wake up in the morning and find out that my dog's semi-okay, well, that's a pretty dang good day. So I just look up and I say, thank God for these old bones. There you go, buddy. Any chance you can do the Blues Man? The Blues Man. Is that the Hank Jr. song? I've never learned it. Or are you thinking of another one? I mean, I could do blues songs all day long if you wanted me to, but I think you're looking for something specific. Let's see. Yeah, Hank Jr. Yeah, I've never worked that one out, Brad, but not to say I won't someday. Maybe by Daryl Palooza. Who knows? When is that? Is that August? Is that right? Can't wait to see you guys. August 3rd is Daryl Palooza. That's exciting. What day is that? Wait. It can't be August 3rd. Can it? I have no way of looking at a calendar right now. Third, so four, Sunday, five, eight, nine, yeah. Okay, yeah, okay, I get it. Request something for Mom Tony and Homer's anniversary. August 2nd, there, okay, that's August 2nd in Van Wert, Ohio. Yes, and then Daryl Palooza on August 3rd. That's right. And then I head out August, probably 6th, to go to Oregon. Not for touring, but I'm heading out. My 40th high school reunion is the 9th, 10th, and 11th. So my wife's not going to see me for half of August. Lucky gal. Request something for Mom and Tony, for Tony and Mom's anniversary. Well, I did the 25, the put another quarter in the ride. What does she like? She likes, maybe I didn't hold you quite as often as I should have. And maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I should have. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Maybe I didn't hold you all those lonely, lonely nights. And I guess I never told you I'm so happy that you're mine. If I made you feel second best,
Girl, I'm sorry I was blind. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Tell me. Tell me that your sweet love hasn't died. Give me one more chance to keep you satisfied. I'll keep you satisfied. Something like that. Mom loves that song, so there you go. They're probably getting ready. I think they're taking a little, trip. Take a little trip. Well, y'all, I got time for one more song, and then I gots to go. I got a lot going on, plus I gotta pick up a dog at the hospital, and I'm gonna have to take care of that dog, said dog. So it's gonna be an interesting day, evening. I gotta cancel a couple of meetings too. But anyways, my last song is, I'm sending this out to me. Because this is kind of where my head is right now, so. A little something that I wrote with Miss Becky, Isles Tear. Just about everything pisses me off. I walk around mad all day. I come into this world middle finger first, and I'm probably going out the same way. Well, you got your rats on the left and your vermin on the right. Keep us riled up cause they like to watch us fight. And if we're all distracted, then we won't even care. When they get out of office, they're all multimillionaires. So just about everything pisses me off. I walk around mad all day. I come into this world middle finger first, and I'm probably going out the same way. Well, you got your kids running around with their faces in their phones. 10 years of college and they live in mama's home. Triggered and they're tweeting, think their life is such a rut. I wish I'd take that hashtag or stick it up their butt. Just about everything pisses me off. Walk around mad all day. I come into this world middle finger first, and I'm probably going out the same way. Well, them Bangladeshi call centers drive me up a wall. Fast food drive-through always gets it wrong. Don't get me started on them freaking robocalls. It's a miracle I'm ever sober at all. Just about everything pisses me off. Walk around mad all day. I come into this world middle finger first, probably going out the same way. I said I'm coming to this world middle finger first, and I'm probably going out the same way. 2, 3, 4. Boy, that's what I was doing yesterday. I'm driving that dog to the hospital. There's blood everywhere. And It's a two-lane road, traffic this way and traffic that way, no opportunity to pass, and everybody in front of me was going 5 to 10 miles under the speed limit the entire drive. I thought I was going to lose my mind, but I didn't. I still have a little mind left, and I was able to remember some songs for y'all to the best of my ability. And I hope when you think about this hour and you're telling your friends about it, you say, Scott tried really hard. He tried really hard. That's what I'd like you to say. And be nice to people. Be nice to yourselves. And I wish y'all a very good weekend wherever you are. UC, stay warm. Everybody else out on the roads, be careful and stay out of my way. See ya. On the road, you know. I'm just being grumpy for a minute. We'll see you later.